Ja, gut. Hotel müssen wir eh machen. We pass the night here. So, was gibt's denn noch zu Nighttime in Irkutsk? From nearby we heard the ferries moving back and forth Lake Baikal, and nearby the mining machines cranked on through the night. The local people do not go out at night, I noticed. I could not tell if it was due to devotion or hard work, or if some terror roamed the streets. Whichever, I followed their example and stayed firmly in bed with a heated brick for company. I trouble you not to play that, but I like it in my presence again. Okay, ich versuche mal nach Peking zu kommen. Freight Train. Open Luggage. Wir haben eine Balalaika und eine Mongol. Salt Lake City, Honolulu. Wir zahlen lieber mehr. Na gut, die 22, die sind auch jetzt nicht. Auch nicht so schlimm. We boarded the steam train from Irkutsk. It was not a passenger service, but was carrying huge quantities of iron. One very slowly indeed. Still, we made ourselves as comfortable as we could. At least we were leaving Russia behind. I do hope you're not spending too much passport to the money, ja, bla bla. Wir conversen mal ein bisschen. Greetings, guard. You two stowaways are comfortable, I trust. Begin conversation, Beijing. I'm very interested in Beijing. They say Empress. Empress. Keine Ahnung, wie das ausspricht. Prefers her automations to be decorative. Von Beijing nach Pyongyang. Könnte man mal fragen. Have you heard the fastest way to Pyongyang von hier? Ist via Vladivostok. Auch echt jetzt? Kanton, Kanton Lahore, Kratnosk. Wo ist denn Lahore? Is there a route from Beijing to Lahore? Here's something I do know. Lahore was once the mythical city of guns. It felt as though we were the only passengers aboard. Perhaps we were. Though I would not have been surprised if the guard had not taken money from a few others and stowed them in the luggage at the Irgendwas Cars. Wait. Danish victory in the cycle race up tower. What the fuck? Okay. Train swept on through endless countryside, getting faster hour by hour as it burned through some of the stocks of coal it carried. We passed the time in conversation, and amongst other things I learned was that you could obtain betel nut boxes in Singapore that will sell for a fortune in Vladivostok. Evening drew in and the train thundered on, seemingly without thought of pause. Ich glaube, er kommt gleich in Urga an. Ja. In the evening of the third day we approached the city of Urga. We had been told nothing about stopping here and had tickets to Beijing, and there seemed no reason to change of our plans. So we stayed aboard. An hour went by, perhaps we refueled, and then we were off once more, rattling away through the bleak, empty steps. So, fuck. Ah, a shave, superb. Wait. African airships will dominate skies. Interessant. A quiet day that passed without incident. The train guard came and went, bringing food, a thin soup in which noodles floating like dying worms. I enjoyed it. I think Monsieur Fogg considered it vile, but he ate all the same. Both of us cannot wait to be in the city. Yeah. Da schmeckt's, glaube ich, dann halt doch besser. Und willkommen in Peking. As we approached Beijing, Monsieur Fogg became increasingly animated, ready for the next step of our journey. The can of engine oil could burn us well here. Und schnell auf den Markt. Und die verkaufen wir hier, aber so viel hat uns das auch wieder nicht gebracht. Wir wollen ja nach Honolulu, das heißt, wir nehmen das hier wieder mit. Ein Caribbean Timetable kaufen wir auch nochmal. Seasickness. Und Heavy Storm. Seasickness Pills. Cold Climate Set. Ich glaube, das tun wir jetzt mal langsam. Aussortieren. Was ist das eigentlich? Part of the Engineer Set. Ne, das lassen wir. Und das hier holen wir uns auch. Achso, das ist ein. So. Erstmal gucken wir uns die Dinger an. Und dann tun wir es gleich wieder verkaufen. Ich habe das Gefühl, dass die haben wir schon mal gesehen. Na gut, Peking müssen eh ein bisschen Exploring betreiben. Wir kommen hier auch nach Hongkong. There were no airships sailing across the Beijing sky, nor any evidence of electrification. Though the Chinese did not shun all technology, even in the richer areas, which a few exceptions to the rule might have been expected. However, I did see a few devices, animated metal and jade dragons, perched on the gables of imperial buildings that snapped and glared at passers-by. Perhaps to discourage thieving. Furthermore, I was lucky enough to catch a performance to the famed Sui Shi Opera, the cast consisting entirely of hydraulic elegances, automata by another name. I was told it was an ancient tradition, begun over 1,000 years ago by Huang Gun, an engineer who had made Sui Shi wine pure. Oh Gott, was sind das für Namen? And musicians, dancing girls and acrobats for his emperor's court. True, perhaps so. But the opera itself, my friends, it was a glorious spectacle, a thing of great beauty, not my taste, utterly terrifying. A glorious spectacle. Though there were few props, the Sui Shi were extravagantly costumed and capable of acrobatics that would press the most of athletic of flesh and blood actors. We were the guest of a Han opium trader, a Manchu court official, who clearly believed us to be spies or troublemakers of some nature, despite my innocent expression, possibly sensing my propensity. Das andere, which was wearing rather false after so many international escapades. As we departed the auditorium, I slipped away from our horse and went backstage, made a polite inquiry about the Dodgers Emperor. Nein, ich mach das hier. I slipped away from our host and went backstage. Ah, my friends, I assure you, only a fraction of the theatrical dramatics take place on stage. My progress was quickly barred by a stage manager wearing a carved jade harpoon and irate expression. What are you doing here? I wish to congratulate the automations on their performance, I said smoothly. The stage manager looked politely bemused. They are rehearsing now, but come with me. She took me through a narrow corridor to the dressing rooms where flesh and blood actors were sitting across from automata. An orchestral engineer was removing the porcelain face from one of the automata up with the delicate care. Up close, I could see that the smooth surface was an illusion. The mask was assembled of a thousand interlocking segments, with which moved according to the mechanisms within. Greetings, I said, and was about to add that we were going around the world, when the engineer stretched the porcelain with her screwdriver. The entire dressing room hushed in horror, while the engineer himself whirled up me in fury. My apologies, madame, if I startle you. Is it serious? Is it serious? I inquired. Do you know what you have done? It's ruined. Utterly ruined, she cried. She threw the once priceless mask up the floor. Get out. I picked up the discarded mask. I picked up the slipping it into a spare pocket before the stage manager ushered me out with crossed arms and a stern look. Ich habe eigentlich gedacht, ich kann die zumindest irgendwie noch retten. I made my way back to the lodgings to meet up with Monsieur Fogg. A pair of opium addicts were slumped in an alley, faces blankly blissful despite the emaciation of their limbs. Glancing into my pocket, I saw the poison and turned my face away. That's in my pocket. Perfect automata face stared implacable back, just as an empty of emotion. Honolulu. Also wir müssen mal planen. Also wir müssen jetzt definitiv nach Honolulu kommen. Nach Vladivostok, nach Pyongyang, Hongkong. Ja, Hongkong ist ein bisschen blöd. Also, wir versuchen nach Vladivostok zu kommen. Will ich doch vorschlagen. Das heißt Amma Hotel. With what remained of the day, I made certain to repack and iron everything. I helped the kitchen staff to clean. I spent a while talking to the hotelier. I helped the kitchen staff to clean. Earning 67 pounds. Ja, wow. Das hat sich ja gelohnt. So. Wir kriegen durch die Reise ein Leben dazu. Alles klar. Dann machen wir das doch. We boarded the Chia Qing, a Chinese junk with billowing pattern sails and a red and gold phoenix painted up its prow, bound for Vladivostok. Do you take passengers often? Or your ship is heavily armed? Your ship is heavily armed, I remarked to Captain Chao, gesturing towards the cast iron carronades up in the desk. Do you expect trouble? Pirates, he agreed, and then added, or war. It was not a surprising response. It had been 10 years since the last Opium War, but European powers and Russia still scratched at China's borders. I spent the first day aboard, eavesdropping, hoping to gather information for our next journey, discovering from a cheerful Javanese soldier that rebellion was brewing in Batavia. As night drew on, incredible stars filled the stars. It was a most peaceful, beautiful moment. Converse. Greetings, Captain. Passepartout. Why, my good man? So, was gibt's in Vladivostok alles? I'm sure you know all about Vladivostok. Vladivostok is the home of the Russian Pacific Fleet. Kommen wir da schon nach Honolulu? Ist der Route vom Vladivostok to Honolulu? Now you listen to me. Some buyers will pay well from Eastern Spices from Honolulu. But tell me, you think Russians will go to war with Japan? Ich denke nein. The Tsar has many other troubles. I agree. It's all bluster. Frag nur mal über Honolulu. What else do you know about Honolulu? That is beyond my remit, Monsieur. Gibt's von Honolulu nach... Oh Gott, wo kommt man da alles hin? Nach Manila vielleicht? Is there a route to Manila? Now you listen to me. You can pick up candles, scented of rose in Manila. Extremely valuable in Hong Kong. Ja gut, aber nach Hong Kong wollen wir ja nicht mehr. Tabintinga, was auch immer das ist. Is there a route from Tabat... Nah, let's just say there is neither hotel, bank or market in Tabatinga. Also wir versuchen in Vladivostok direkt nach Honolulu zu kommen. I saw Captain Chow reading a Chinese newspaper at breakfast and asked if he would tell me the news. Ja, natürlich. He pressed his lips together. It's out of date. The Shen Pao is printed in Shanghai and I only pick it up when I happen to dock there. Do you have any English newspapers? Ich nehme an. What is the most interesting story? The paper is campaigning against the employment of young women in opium bars and in the French concession. He pointed at the article in question. As they often ask to perform immoral services. They should campaign against the opium bars altogether, I huffed. Captain Chow looked delicately surprised. I am surprised to hear a foreigner say such a thing. I spent a stimulating afternoon in discussions with Captain Chow as the wind filled our fully battened sails and speed us on our way to Vladivostok. The Chia King had to dart between the bustly chunks, filling the harbor to find a space to dock. I was keen to see what Vladivostok has to offer, or I found Vladivostok to be quite intimidatingly material. Yeah, so. Stepped off the boat eagerly to hurry after my master into the city. Langsam kann ich nicht mehr sprechen. Was gibt's denn hier? Die Indian Time Travel Set brauche ich auch nicht mehr. Traveling Ding brauche ich auch nicht. Brauche ich jetzt hier nicht. Eigentlich muss ich nicht wirklich was. Nicht wirklich was verkaufen. Ja, gut. Wir tun mal ein bisschen Vladivostok. Durchgucken. The military port of Vladivostok looked over to the calm black water of the Sea of Japan and was populated largely by sailors of the Far East fleet and a mix of Chinese, Korean and Russian residents. I visited Matroska Soblada sailor town. Ja, natürlich. A hastily constructed a set of low buildings sprawling from the harbor. Sailors drank lemon tea or vodka in every doorway and talked only of one thing, the possibility of war with Japan. I slithered over to a young man was for drink, a female communications officer, who sighed heavily. It is the railway. Japan fears how close Moscow has become. Is Japan right to be afraid? Or also, ich rede hier gerade seit mindestens 2 Stunden ununterbrochen. Langsam wird meine Stimme, ist die Stimme weg. The real world is growing smaller. Ich habe real garantiert falsch ausgesprochen. I observed. Yes, just so. Britain and France have their empires in Indochina, and the Tsar is looking eastwards as well. After all, on a clear day, you can almost see the shores of Japan from here, a stubborn thought. The hour was getting late by the time I made it back to my hotel, but my adventure here was far from over. An imposing Imperial Army officer accosted me in reception and subjected me to a thorough search. I gave no objection, and he studiously went through our cases and my pockets, although of course he found nothing seditious. Vladivostok is a closed port, he declared. You will be held while a decision is taken in your case. I attempted to plaster my way through in dramatic fashion. Frankly, I was glad of the rest. I pleaded with him. I attempted to plaster my way through in dramatic fashion with an elegant, heart-wrenching tale, a stirring tale of abduction, so on. A heart-wrenching tale of poor innocent tourists preyed on by the Siberian thieves. It brought a tear to his bureaucratic eye. You will find our accommodation much more hospitable, he declared, though I cannot let you move on directly. And so it was that we came to spend 3 nights in a Russian military jail, not an experience I would recommend even for the hardest of travelers. When we finally released, it was without much discussion. We were pointed to the docks and told to leave, and quickly. I'm in a hurrying health, but we must take haste. Ja, das sollten wir ganz schnell nehmen. Auch hier nehmen wir ihm wieder Leben zu. So, go. Das ist ein Korean Ship. We avoided Russian military ships and instead took a passage on a Korean vessel crewed by a mix of Koreans, Mongolians and Siberians who regarded Monsieur Fogg with grave curiosity. I tried to dismiss their attention. I considered charging a pound for a look at him. I might have made 20 pounds. They continued to goggle at my master in my disbelief until he retreated below deck with the slightest of furrows etching his brow. Fuck. For the first day aboard, we kept ourselves mostly to ourselves. The crew seemed busy with their tasks, and I was happy to have fewer of those myself. In all honesty, I did not like the look of most of them. Monsieur Fogg was his usual imperious self, however, and made his calculations and read his newspaper. Meanwhile, the boat steamed onwards. Converse. Greetings, mademoiselle. Good day, Frenchman. Yokohama, Honolulu. It seems quite impossible to me. Wir wissen es aber schon. Irgendwie unnütz. No idea, but how? But now. I hear that Pang Su Pass is the easiest way from India to China. But tell me, I've learned to tie my own shoelaces. Good. What the fuck, okay. Interessiert mich eigentlich alles nicht. So. One of the cabin girls, Elena, spoke good English and was attached to us as a translator, though she created as much conversation as she explicated. Do you know my parents, adopted, since I have only just met you? Elena nodded. My father was a Russian officer, maybe. I think, and Mama comes from a famous Cossack family. They are all soldiers. A Russian officer, maybe. Your Mama is a soldier, I blinked. She dressed as a boy and joined the Cossack hosts. Elena wrinkled her nose. My auntie and grandmama were soldiers too, Mama says. But I have to earn enough money for my own horse and armor before I can join. I blinked down at the little cabin girl, rather at a loss as how I could respond. That's nice, but that's terrible. Ich mach mal, that's nice. I hazarded and she nodded enthusiastically. Mama runs the boiler room. All sailors are frightened of her, she told me rather wistfully. One day I will be like her. Elena made a mock fierce face and presented to Craig in terror until we both began laughing uproariously. Also laut einfach. More seriously, a friend in the boiler room was useful. I would like to meet her, I said, and Elena giggled with delight. I will ask, she replied. Fuck. Elena knocked on my door unreasonably early in the morning, eyes bright. Mama says she wants to meet you. She seized my arm. Will you come? Lead the way, mademoiselle. We descended into the bowels of the ship. I felt the heat and noise of the engine before I saw it. The rumbling whistle of the boilers, the shouts of a woman with muscular arms, sheened with sweat and hair shorn to her ears, preceded over the activity with well-worn confidence. She glanced over to us and grunted. I bowed deeply. I grunted in return, and she gave me a courteous nod of approval while Elena chattered away in an unintelligible dialect. The formidable woman regarded her daughter with a certain detachment with masked deep adoration was most unnatural. Deep adoration. The girl bloomed underneath her mama's merest glance. We took our leave soon after, and Elena smiled at me radiantly. Isn't she wonderful, she breathed. I nodded enthusiastically, kept my thoughts to myself, but Elena barely seemed to notice. Wait. Elena laughed as I hung over the ship's rail to get a better view of Yokohama as we neared the port. She gave me a hug goodbye, which surprised me, though her mother watched me with hard eyes throughout our exchange. We waved at her as the sun set. It lit the foreign flags in the harbor with bright fire as it dripped below the horizon. Ich würde sagen, wir geben uns jetzt noch auf den Weg nach Honolulu. Und dann. Ach du Scheiße. Salt Lake City sollte man anscheinend besuchen. Part of the Heavy Storm Set. English Wardrobe Set, ganz ehrlich. So. Ja, stimmt. Abends sind wir auch noch. Tomorrow at 8 a.m. Da müssen wir ganz, ganz schön flink sein. So. Hotel. As night fell, I made certain to repack and iron everything, ran a few errands for the hotel. I went out to explore a little and found a remarkably frenetic Japanese clerk who had mislaid a locket, which I spotted and would then inform me that you could pick up zoetrope in Manila, extremely valuable in Beijing. I thanked him. We were unlikely to wait with my friend. I can't say I disagree. So, depart. Wir müssen leider $650 oder Pfund. Naja. Aber ab in Richtung Honolulu. Und damit, meine Freunde, mache ich erstmal eine Aufnahmepause. Wir haben quasi die Hälfte vom Spiel geschafft in einer Session. Ich habe die meiste Zeit noch vorgelesen, habe garantiert die Hälfte falsch ausgesprochen. Aber gut. Soll uns egal sein. Ich glaube, das waren jetzt ungefähr 2,5 Stunden, wenn ich der Uhr da trauen kann. Und wenn ich meinem Gedächtnis trauen kann. Naja, wir sehen uns. Wir hören uns bald wieder. Vielleicht dann auch auf einem anderen Rechner. Mit höherer Aufnahmequalität. Wer weiß, ob die Folgen überhaupt veröffentlicht werden. Ich weiß es nicht. Auf jeden Fall. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.